Okay, so now let us discuss about the psychosexual stages of development by Sigmund Freud. So in these stages of development, we have five. So for you to easily remember, just remember OA palagi. So OA palagi, that is oral, anal, phallic, latency, and genital. So let us first discuss about the oral stage. So this occurs from birth to 1 year. So in the first stage of psychosexual development, the libido is centered in the baby's mouth. So during the oral stages, the baby gets much satisfaction from putting all sorts of things in its mouth to satisfy the libido and thus its id demand. So dito po nag-uumpisa yung weaning or gratification, like let's say for example, sucking, biting, eating, or breastfeeding. So Freud said the oral stimulation could lead to an oral fixation in later life. So yung tinatawag nating oral fixation, we can see this oral personality all around, like let's say for example, yung mga smokers, nail biters, finger chewers, and thumb suckers. So oral personalities engage in such oral behaviors. They usually occur when under stress. So the adult traits, yung mga traits na pwede magkaroon yung adult, kapag nagkaroon ng problem sa oral stage, it can be optimism, gullibility, dependency, pessimism, passivity, hostility, sarcasm, and aggression. Next stage, we have the anal stage. So this is from 1 to 3 years old, and the libido becomes focused on the anus. So the child now is fully aware that they are a person in their own right, that their wishes can bring them into conflict with the demand of the outside world. So ibig sabihin, their ego is now developed. So Freud believed that this type of conflict, ayan, yung ang pinaka-conflict or experience natin dito is their potty training or toilet training. So the nature of the first conflict with authority is now their gratification from expelling and withholding their feces sa kanilang defecation na. So, kapag nagkaroon po ng problem during this stage, pwede pong magkaroon ng traits during their adult, excessive cleanliness. So, dito po nabubuo yung mga obsessive compulsive disorder, orderliness, stinginess, messiness, rebelliousness, and destructiveness. So, meron po tayong term na tinatawag na anal retentive. So, ito yung personality who hates mess. So, they are obsessively tidy, punctual, and respectful of authority. Next is the phallic stage. So, phallic stage naman po is from 3 to 5 years old or 6 years old. And the libido now is in their genitals. So the child becomes aware of anatomical sex differences. Alam na nila their gender or their sex differences. And it says motion, the conflict between erotic attraction, resentment, rivalry, jealousy, and fear, which Freud called the Oedipus complex kapag sa mga lalaki, and meron naman tayong tinatawag na electro complex sa babae. So yung Oedipus complex class, it derives from the Greek myth. Si Oedipus, isa siyang batang lalaki na pinatay yung kanyang tatay just to marry his mother. So itong Oedipus complex, it arises because the boy develops sexual desires for his mother, and he wants to possess his mother exclusively and get rid of his father to enable him to do so. Next is the Electra complex. Ito naman po, the girl desires the father but realizes that she does not have a penis. penis. So, nagkakaroon po siya ng penis envy and wish to be a boy. So, dito sa Electra Complex, hindi lang siya yung batang babae o yung anak na babae nagkakaroon ng gusto sa kanyang tatay. So, pwede din sa itong, dito po sa Electra Complex, nabubuo yung kanilang pagkakaroon ng gender identity or sexual orientation bilang lesbian or bisexual sa mga babae. Next is the Latin C. This is from 6 years old or 5 years old to puberty. So, the Latin C stage is the fourth stage of psychosexual pero wala pong libido or doon sa part ng body nagfo-focus kasi ito yung period na they are sexually calm and yung kanilang interest is more on school, hobbies, or sa kanilang friends. Kasi dito, sabi nga, is latency. Kapag sinabi natin latency or latent, it means hidden siya. So, much of the child's energy is channeled into developing new skills and acquiring new knowledge. And play becomes largely confined to other children of the same gender. And the last stage of psychosexual development is the genital. So, this is from puberty onwards to adult. Ayan. So, the genital stage, it is the time of adolescent sexual experimentation. So, dito na po nagkakaroon ng sexual interest and nagkakaroon na po sila or they are settling down with one-to-one relationship, especially for those person in 20s. So, sexual instinct is directed to heterosexual pleasure rather than self-pleasure like during the phallic stage. So, dito po, nagkakaroon po ng establishment ng mature sexual relationship. So, ayun po yung psychosexual stages of development. We have the oral, anal, phallic, latency, and genitals. So, now let us move on with Eric Erickson, psychosocial stages of development. So, ito pong psychosocial stages of development, we have 8 different stages. So, from unahin natin, yung, syempre, from infancy, we have the basic trust and versus mistrust. So, dito po, it is the first stage. So, 0 to 1 year old ito. Sa basic trust versus mistrust. So, ang important event natin dito is more on feeding and the resolution or the outcome or virtue is hope. So, the first stage na ito, na trust versus mistrust, it is the most fundamental stage in life. Because dito sa baby, they are utterly dependent and they are developing their trust base dun sa binibigay nating care sa kanila. So, at this point in development, the child is utterly dependent upon adult caregivers for everything they need to survive. Like, let's say, for example, food, love, warm safety, and others. So, if the child successfully develops trust, the child will feel safe and secure in the world. However, kapag naman hindi tayo naging successful na ma-build itong stage na ito, the child, pwedeng magkaroon sila ng fear, magkaroon sila ng mistrust, or maging inconsistent and unpredictable sila. So, the culmination in old age is the appreciation of interdependence and relatedness. Next is during the early childhood, 1 to 3 years old, we have the autonomy versus shame or autonomy versus shame and doubt. So, it takes place during the early childhood and focus on children developing a greater sense of personal control. So, dito na po nag-uumpisa yung tinatawag nating role of independence. So, at this point, children are just starting to gain a little independence and they are starting to perform basic actions on their own. And usually, they can make decisions on their own or about what they prefer to eat and all. So, dito po sa autonomy versus shame and doubt, just like Freud, so, nag-uumpisa po yung toilet training nila dito. So, the child who struggles and who are shamed for their sense of personal control, pwede silang magkaroon ng feeling of shame and doubt. So, the resolution or the virtue is will, and the culmination in old age is acceptance of the cycle of life from integration to disintegration. For next stage naman tayo during the play age, 3 to 6 years old, we have the stage number 3, initiative versus guilt. So at this point, children begin to assert their power and control over the world through directing play and other social interactions. So children who are successful at this stage feel capable and able to lead the others. So dito po nabubuo yung kanilang initiative. Just like sabi nga natin kanina, nafe-feel na nila dito that they are able na mag-lead ng others. Okay, so ang ating resolution or virtue is yung purpose, and the culmination in old age is humor, empathy, and resilience. Next stage, number 4, is the industry versus inferiority. So approximately, it is during school age, 6 to 12 years old. So this on this stage, through social interactions, children begin to develop a sense of pride in their accomplishment and ability. So nag-uumpisa na po yung kanilang virtue or yung outcome ng pagiging competent, o ayun yung kanilang virtue, competence. And the culmination in old age, humility, acceptance of the course of one's life, and unfulfilled hopes. And stage number 5, we have the identity versus confusion, or identity versus role confusion. And so this occurs during the teenage years or the adolescence. So this stage plays an essential role in developing a sense of personal identity, which will continue to influence behavior and development for the rest of a person's life. So dito nabubuo or nag-uumpisang mag-develop yung sense of self and personal identity. So, kapag nagkaroon tayo ng success, ay magkakaroon po tayo ng ability to stay sa kanilang true self. And kapag naman nag-failure, syempre, it will lead to role confusion and weak sense of self. So, ang resolution or virtue is fidelity, and culmination in old age, sense of complexity of life, merging in sensory, logical, and aesthetic perception. Next is the intimacy versus isolation. So this is for young adults or early adulthood, 20 to 25 years old. So dito po nag-uumpisa ng love relationship. So kapag nagkaroon po tayo ng success dito, it can lead to strong relationship, and failure naman is loneliness and isolation. So again, the virtue is love, and the culmination in old age, sense of complexity of relationship, value of tenderness, and loving freely. Next, stage number 7, which is generativity versus stagnation. So adult needs to create or nurture things that will outlast them. So often by having family or creating positive change that benefits other people. So dito, nagkakaroon na po tayo ng parang nasa-sense na natin yung ating pagiging successful during this phase, and siguro by this time, meron na po tayo na contribute sa ating community, ganyan. So failure to attain this skill will feel that you are unproductive and uninvolved. So, ayun po, generativity versus stagnation during adulthood, 26 to 64 years old, the virtue is care and culmination in old age, caritas, or caring for others, and agape, empathy, and concern. And lastly, we have the stage 8 or the last stage ng ating psychosocial. We have the integrity versus despair. So this is for old age, 65 years old, up to death. So this is the final psychosocial stage. And it is more on reflecting back on life. So at this point of development, people look back on the events of their lives and determine if they are happy with the life that they lived or nagre-regret ba sila sa mga bagay na ginawa or hindi nila ginawa. So the virtue is wisdom and the culmination is the existential identity, a sense of integrity strong enough to withstand physical disintegration. So again, let us repeat the 8 stages of psychosocial theory of Erik Erikson. We have trust versus mistrust, autonomy versus shame and doubt, initiative versus guilt, industry versus inferiority, identity versus role confusion, intimacy versus isolation, generativity versus stagnation, and integrity versus despair. Okay, so now let us talk about John Piaget's stages of cognitive development. So we have 4 different stages of cognitive development. So first we have the sensory motor. So this is from 0 to 2 years old. So in the sensory motor stage, children primarily learn about their environment through their senses and motor activity. So the sensory motor stage comprises 6 sub-stages. So dito po gumagamit na sila ng reflexes, 0 to 2 years old, primary circular reaction. So nagkakaroon na po sila ng different sensory organs during 1 to 4 months old. And then during 4 to 8 months old, meron na po silang secondary circular reactions. So dito na po nag-uumpisa yung kanilang responses to their external body. And then during 8 to 12 months old, the coordination of secondary schemes. So at this point, yung behavior ng children, they become more goal-oriented. And then we also have the tertiary circular reactions. Nagkakaroon na po ng performing of same actions and nagkakaroon po ng trying ng new behaviors and actions to achieve different results. And yung pang-anim naman na sub-stage ni sensory motor is the mental combination. So it occurs 18 to 24 years old. So dito na po sila nag-uumpisang mag-solve ng puzzles or yung mga Legos, and they are using their gestures and words to communicate. So, tandaan lang natin kay sensory motor, the children can identify object permanence. So, the ibig sabihin ni object permanence, the object still exists when out of sight. And also, the recognition of ability to control objects and act intentionally. The next stage is the pre-operational stage. So this is 2 to 7 years old. So at the end of this, children start to use mental abstractions. So meron na po silang ability to use mental representations rather than the physical appearance of object or people. So they begin now to use language, and meron na po tayong tinatawag na egocentric thinking. So this is the difficulty seeing things from other viewpoints. And they can now classify objects by single features. So for example, color. Next is the third stage, which is the concrete operational, 7 to 11 years old. So the children begins to solve problem because they can consider numerous outcomes and perspectives. And mas nag-develop na yung kanilang cognitive abilities like logical thinking, and they can now recognize conservation of numbers, mass, and weight. Also, they can now classify objects by several features and can place them in order. And the last stage of cognitive development is the formal operational, 11 years old onwards. So, at the age of 11, nagkakaroon na po ng abstract concepts or abstract propositions. So, they can now think hypothetically and think of the future, and they can create hypotheses and tests. So, during this stage, children are capable of hypothetical deductive reasoning, which allow them to test hypotheses and draw conclusions from the results. So again, what are the four stages of cognitive development? We have sensory motor, pre-operational, concrete operational, and formal operational. Okay, so now let us discuss about Lawrence Kohlberg theory on the moral development. So, we have here three stages. Ayan. So, we have here the level 1, the pre-conventional. So, ito pong pre-conventional, we have two steps here. So, the punishment and obedience orientation. So, dito na po nag-uumpisa ang mga bata para mag-obey or sumunod sa mga rules para maiwasan ang punishment. Next, the conventional morality. So this is from early adolescence to adulthood, 7 to 11 years old, the conventional stage. So we have developing good interpersonal relationship, ayan, good or boy, good boy or good girl morality, and conforms to avoid disapproval or dislike by others. So, kay conventional good boy or good girl morality, and they conform to avoid censure of authorities. So, they maintain social order in this level. And then level 3 is the post-conventional, 11 onwards. So, they now form social contract and individual rights. They maintain communities and emphasis on individual rights, and they are now aware of their universal principle. So, ayan. Pag-usapan natin yung stages and levels. So, for stage number 1, we have the obedience and punishment. So, the earliest stage of moral development, these are especially common in young children or infants. So, according to Kohlberg, people at this stage see rules as fixed and absolute. So, wala pong difference between doing right thing and avoiding punishment. So, stage number 2 is all about self-interest or individualism. So, this occurs during preschool. So, interest shifts to rewards rather than punishment. So, effort is made to secure greatest benefit for oneself. Dito naman tayo sa blue side. This is for the conventional. We have the developing good interpersonal relationship or conformity and interpersonal accord. So, this is during school age. So, sabi nga natin kanina, good boy or good girl level ito. And effort is made to secure approval and maintain friendly relations. So, next naman tayo is the stage 4, the authority and social order, or maintaining social order. So, this stage is focused on ensuring that social order is maintained, and at this stage, orientation toward fixed rules, the purpose of morality is maintaining social order, and interpersonal accord is expanded to include the entire society. So, ang focus natin dito is to maintain law and order by following the rules, doing one's duty, and respecting the authority. Last is the post-conventional stage or level. We have the social contract and the individual rights. So, this is during teens. So, mutual benefit reciprocity. Morally right and legally right are not always the same. utilitarian rules that make life better for everyone. So the ideas of a contract or a social contract cause people in the next stage to begin to account for the differing values, opinions, and beliefs of other people. Next naman is the universal principle. So this is during adulthood. So morality is based on principles that transcend mutual benefit. So dito sa final level ng moral reasoning ni Kohlberg, it is based on universal ethical principle and abstract reasoning. So yung mga tao at this stage, they now follow yung tinatawag nating universal principles of justice, and sinusunod na nila yung law and rules. Ayan, so they are more on the moral side. And that is all for Kohlberg's theory. So we have three stages. Yung three stages natin, we have itong first stage or level, we have the pre-conventional, second level is the conventional, and the third level is post-conventional. Under nung bawat level, we have different six stages. So under pre-conventional, we have the obedience or punishment, and then self-interest. Under conventional, we have conformity and interpersonal accord, and then authority and social order. And last, para sa post-conventional, we have social contract and universal principles. Okay, so now let us talk about Lev Vygotsky. Okay, so unahin natin yung kanyang theory on language development. Ayan, sa language muna tayo, class. Okay, so Lev Vygotsky's theory of language development in children. So we have the primitive stage. So, sa baby, nagkakaroon po ng mga words like goo, ga, pwede silang mag-umiyak, and bubble. So, these are examples of primitive stage of language development. So, the sound produced served no real purpose except to produce the sound and experiment with our new capability. So, just as a baby laid on his belly, make crawling motions, yet not crawl. So, the baby may also make sounds without producing speech. So, dito, hindi pa po nakakapag-produce ng speech, pero meron na po silang sound na ginagawa. So, there is also not verbal thought or internal monologue. So, hindi, ibig sabihin na ito, no, hindi nag-iisip yung mga bata. It only means that the child has not yet internalized his speech. Next stage is the naive stage. So as the child begins to speak, he learns how to say words far before he learns their meaning and functions. For example, the word ball. So to the child, this one word can mean a variety of things. Pag sinabi ng bata na ball, pwedeng ibig sabihin nun, nasan yung ball, or give me the ball, or buy me a ball, ganyan. So, to an adult with an established knowledge of language, this word refers to a child's toy. Pero sa isang bata, marami siyang meaning. Kasi isang word lang yung sabihin nila, pero it can mean a variety of things. That is the naive stage. Next is the external stage. So, during external stage, the child begins to use external objects to represent words. So, they can use flashcards, objects, or fingers when counting. Another example would be use of his name to remember letters and the sound they make. So, dito na po nag-uumpisa yung tinatawag nating rhyming. So, pwede natin gamitin ito to improve memory and sound recognition. Next stage is the ingrowth stage. So, as the child's egocentric speech turns inward, he enters the final stage. So, he uses the skills he has acquired to perform logical tasks internally. So, rather than counting aloud like 1, 2, 3, he will count in his head using part of his short-term memory. So, like let's say for example, when we are solving. Like, let's say, for example, addition, you will not count using your fingers. You can count in your head. You can form pictures that will form the number na ina-add mo. Okay? So, ayan. To reiterate the language development by Lev Vygotsky, from 1 to 6 months old, nagkakaroon na po ng ku or gu and ga. Sa mga baby, 6 to 12 months, nagkakaroon na po sila ng bubbling sound like dada, baba, mama. And then 12 to 18 months, pwede na po mag-umpisa yung kanilang first word. That, like, let's say, for example, yung kanilang ball, teddy, and all. 18 to 24 years old, the toddlers begin to join two words together. Ayan. Like, let's say, for example, give ball, more teeth, or play more. Next is 2 to 3 years old, pwede na pong makapagbuo ng sentence yung bata. Like, let's say, for example, mommy, give me the ball. Mommy, can you please fix it? Mommy, I'm hungry. So, that is the language development according to Lev Vygotsky. Now, let's go back to Zone of Proximal Development. Zone of Proximal Development by Lev Vygotsky. Or the ZPD. So, as you can see, we have the ZPD diagram. And it is defined as the space between what a learner can do and what a learner cannot do without help. Ayan. Again, the zone of proximal development is defined as the space between what a learner can do without assistance and what a learner can do with adult guidance or in collaboration with more capable peers. So, dito po, meron po tayong tinatawag na MKO or yung more knowledgeable other. So, for example, a child cannot solve problems. But with the help of the MKO, yung more knowledgeable other, nagkakaroon po tayo ng tinatawag na scaffolding. Yung help, di ba, when we are building establishments, merong scaffolding. And that scaffolding serve as the guide para mas mapatibay yung ginagawang establishment or bahay or building. And ganun din si ZPD. So, si MKO, nagbibigay siya ng guide or ng scaffolding doon sa batang hindi kayang mag-solve ng problem. And with his or her help or scaffolding, they can now solve independently. So, that is how ZPD or Zone of Proximal Development works. And now, let us move on with the last theory of learner's development, which is the ecological system by Yuri Bronfenbrenner. So we have here the microsystem, but wait, let me show you the ecological system. Ayan. So this is how ecological systems theory looks like. So as you can see, we have here the child, and the immediate environment is the microsystem, and then the connections na tinatawag is the mesosystem, indirect environment, the exosystem, and the social and cultural values, that is the macrosystem. And the last layer is the chronosystem that changes over time. So, let us discuss it one by one. So, unahin natin si microsystem. So, the prefix micro comes from the Greek word means small. So, ito yung una na layer of nested system. So, it encompasses an individual's human relationship, interpersonal interactions, and immediate surroundings. So, example ng microsystem is yung kanilang parents, siblings, or school environment. Next is the mesosystem. It is the second layer from the individual surrounding and encompassing the different interactions between the character of microsystem. So, example is the relationship between individuals, family, and their school teachers or administrators. So, in order for an interaction to be considered part of the mesosystem, it has to be a direct interaction between two aspects of microsystem that influences the development of the individual. So this is just like the mutual relationship with your family. So ayun yung tinatawag nating mesosystem. Next is the exosystem. It is the third layer and it contains the elements of microsystem which do not affect the individual directly but may do so indirectly. So for example, if a parent were to lose their job or have their hours cut back, so this would affect their child in an indirect way, such as financial strain or increased parental stress. Next layer is the macro system. It means, the macro means large, and it is used because this system was thought to be all-encompassing. So, ito pong pang-apat and the outermost layer of the biological model, it encompasses cultural and societal beliefs and programming the influence of an individual's development. So, for example, is the gender norms or religious influence. So, Bronfenbrenner's early model of bioecological system has sometimes been criticized for not emphasizing the active role of the individual in his or her own development. So as such, sometimes the individual's own biological and identifying characteristics such as age, health, sex, or gender are considered the unofficial first layer of the nested system. Kasi nga, they can be influenced by their social and cultural norms. So in later interactions, the fifth stage is considered part of the bioecological model, which is the chronosystem. So this system focuses on the interaction between the various systems and how they can affect one another over time. So for instance, this would be parents scolding a child for disobedience, which is an instance microsystem-macrosystem interaction. While the parents are the members of microsystem, they are reinforcing a cultural belief that children should always listen to their parents. So that is how chronosystem works. So to reiterate, the bioecological systems theory of Yuri Bronfenbrenner, again, we have the microsystem, mesosystem, exosystem, macrosystem, and chronosystem. And that is the end of our fourth lesson that is all about theories on learner's development. So I hope that you reach the last part of this video lecture. And I hope that you learned something today. God bless everyone and always keep safe.